Now let's talk about B due to cylindrical wire, a cylindrical conductor. If the current is passing in this direction, then again we'll have to take the Amperean loop. Now here the Amperean loop can be outside and inside. So B due to cylindrical wire, let's draw a picture. The current is passing in this direction, suppose, then we take 1 Amperean loop here and 1 Amperean loop outside and 1 Amperean loop inside. So let's consider that this is first loop, this is second loop, this is third loop. Now here, let this radius of cross section of the cylinder be capital R. The Amperean loop radius be R. So in first loop, R is greater than capital R. In second loop, R is equal to R. And in third loop, which is inner loop, R is less than R. Now let's tackle all the three. In first loop, R is greater than R. In second loop, R is equal to R. In third loop, R is less than R. So, in the first loop, if you take this as Amperean loop, then by applying the Ampere circuital law, this is for first loop, I am doing B times DL, this DL is nothing but 2 pi R, because we are considering circular loops only, which is equal to mu naught times of I. Therefore, B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi R. So, it tells us that B is directly proportional to I, inversely proportional to R. This is B1. Now, for second loop, this is first result. For second loop, again, I should take the Amperean loop, but this time, the radius of the Amperean loop is capital R. So, I can write directly B times 2 pi R, which is equal to mu naught times of I. Now, B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi capital R. If you observe this B1, now let's observe the B2. Mu naught I is same, numerator is same in both the two cases. But in the denominator, R is greater than R here. Therefore, B1 is lesser than B2. Now, let us do it for B3. That is, R is less than R. Now this current we have to, the current threaded in this circle only you have to find. So if you want to find, suppose this is solenoid or this is a cylindrical conductor, and I wanted to know through this, that means the entire current is not passing through, but some portion of current is passing through it. So that current I have to take. So when R is less than R, B times, of course, 2 pi R I can take, is all equal to mu naught I enclosed. In the cross-sectional area of pi R square, I current is there. So what about the cross-section of pi small r square? So I have to take I by unitary method pi capital R square times pi small r square. So this pi can be cancelled, and then I can replace this I by I times R square by capital R square. Now, what should be the value of B here? I can cancel out 1R, and then I can finally write B is equal to mu naught times I by 2 pi R square times small r. So here it is, B is directly proportional to R. Now, if you plot a graph for this, here B and here R, if you take, inside, that is R is less than R, B is directly proportional to R according to this result. Therefore, we get a straight line, and maximum at R is equal to R, and then it goes 1 over R. So this would be representing the graph for this situation.